We're collecting water from the Columbia River, which we will then take down to Lake Mead, and we are going to grow quagga mussels in the Columbia River water and see how well they might be able to survive if they were to get introduced into the Columbia River. The Columbia River has much lower levels of dissolved calcium than Lake Mead. In fact, it's low enough that some people predict that quagga mussels won't do well. And what we want to do is test that and get empirical data that shows whether or not that's true.
This last summer, we collected a lot of lake samples from around the Northwest and looked at the calcium levels in the lakes, and hopefully we'll be able to look at the growth rate from this Lake Mead experiment and decide where the greatest risk is for quagga mussel invasions.
We're going to set up a big trough in the hatchery down there with a water bath that will keep everything at a constant temperature. In that trough there will be individual cups. Each cup will hold a mussel, and in those cups we'll have Columbia River water, some of it supplemented with calcium, some of it not, and then we'll also have Lake Mead water as a control. And we're just going to look and see how well they grow, see if there's any difference in mortality rates between the treatments, things like that, to kind of get an idea of how they would perform in the Columbia River system.
The implications of mussels getting into the Columbia would be significant?
Yes, they would have both environmental and economic impacts. They could take over the system and starve out a lot of the native organisms that live in the Columbia River. And as far as economic damage, they are very prolific, and they love to attach to things like intake pipes and docks and ropes, and can interrupt the function of some of the, could potentially interrupt the functioning of some of the dams, so it could be quite a problem.